إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, من أصول الإيمان اعتقاد لقاء الله سبحانه وتعالى. One of the fundamental principles of faith is to believe that you will meet Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وهذا تحت الركن الخامس من أركان الإيمان. And this comes under the fifth article of the articles of faith. They believe in Allah, they believe in the angels, they believe in the books, they believe in the messengers, they believe in the day of resurrection. Number five, والقدر خيره وشره. And they believe in القدر. فيو must have a firm belief that you will meet Allah سبحانه وتعالى without any shadow of doubt in your heart. You will stand front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى if he wills. وهذا ثابت. This is established by evidence في القرآن. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه. O mankind, surely you're ever striving to meet your Lord, and you shall meet him. تفسير هذه الآية, the meaning of this verse, Ibn Abbas combined striving with deeds, because some of the scholars of tafsir said that you will meet your deeds, you will see the result of your deeds. Ibn Abbas gathered the two. He said, you shall strive to do deeds, whether righteous, whether wicked, and you will meet Allah with these deeds. So he gathered the meaning of Allah and the meaning of the deeds. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث جبريل, حديث أبي هريرة, mentioned this literally. When جبريل عليه السلام came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a form of a man, and he asked him the three famous questions. The second question, وما الإيمان? What is faith? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وبكتبه وبلقائه. In one of the wording, that you believe in Allah, angels, books, and that you will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ورد دعاء الاستفتاح في صلاة التهجد حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما في الصحيحين. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would wake up for tahajjud at night, he would make this دعاء. اللهم لك الحمد أنت نور السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن ولك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض ومن فيهن وفيه ولقاؤك حق. في الدعاء يعني your meeting is out of question, true. وفي حديث عدي بن حاتم في الصحيحين قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما منكم من أحد إلا وسيكلمه ربه ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان فينظر أيمن منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم وينظر أشأم منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم ثم ينظر بين يديه فلا يرى إلا النار فاتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. None of you but will speak to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will speak to one on one. معنى الحديث يعني هذا والشاهد. ف it is established. وبعدين يعني the beauty of this اعتقاد يا إخوة, the beauty of this belief, and that what distinguishes a believer from somebody who's out there doing as he please. يعني سبحان الله, this confines your mission. If you came from Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created you, and you shall return to Allah, so you better return with something. غير الكافر, different to a disbeliever. يعني we were grown up with this song, جئت لا أدري من أين أتيت. I came, I have no clue, where did I come from? How did I came to this world? I don't know. ولكني أتيت, but here I am. طب what I'm doing here? بصرت طريقا قدامي فمشيت. I'm just doing as I please. Nothing that guard me, nothing that govern me. Nothing. Do as I wish. This type doesn't believe that he will meet Allah. Actually, he is not hoping for that meeting. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَاطْمَأَنُّوا بِهِ. That type, they do not hope to meet Allah. They are happy with the dunya. And they have no clue. They are in a state of heedlessness about what to come. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا غَافِلُونَ أولئك مأواهم النار. بس المسلم المؤمن, a believer in this, a believer in this, he has already set his work, his agenda. إن لله عبادا فطنا طلقوا الدنيا وخافوا الفتنة لما علموا أنها ليست لحي سكنا جعلوها لجة وجعلوا صالح الأعمال فيها سفنة. Allah has smart people, creation, عباد, servants. Servants of His who are smart. They knew that they will die and they will meet Allah and this world is just a matter of time. When they figure this out, they divorced the dunya. They said to the dunya, I divorce you, I divorce you, I divorce you. Even so it counts as one time. But they said that. And they prepared for that meeting. Here is the essence of this. Some people do love that meeting. And some people do hate that meeting. And when the Prophet ﷺ made that statement, when he said that,
ده صحابة got confused. الحديث في البخاري كتاب الرقاق حديث عبادة بن الصامت رضي الله عنه. Here is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said. من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه. Whosoever loves to meet Allah, Allah will love to meet him. ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. And whoever hates to meet Allah, Allah will hate to meet him. طبعا الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم توته الصحابة اعلموا أنكم لن ترون ربكم حتى تموتوا. Rest assured that you will never be able to see Allah in this world, but you will see him after you die, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the first evidence that refute the claim of the Antichrist that he is a Lord. Mahua, the Antichrist will come into this world and telling you what? I'm your Lord, worship me. The fact that I'm able to see you in this world, that means you're not my Lord. Because you cannot see Allah in this world. You can't. His greatness, His divine greatness cannot be absorbed in your little body. But you will be reshaped to be able to see Him in the next life, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So based on this, the fact that we're not going to be able to see Allah unless we die, right away, أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها أو أحد من أزواجه or another one of his wives, she said, يا رسول الله, look, ومن منا لا يكره الموت. Because if you're unable to see Allah unless you die, that means you have to love death. To love to meet Allah. Because death is what will enable you to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who doesn't hate death? We all hate death. He said, this is not it, ya Aisha. ليس الأمر كذلك. The matter is not that. Then he started explaining a scene, ya ikhwa, that is out of this world. The scene of death. When our souls are being extracted out of our bodies. Out of this world. طبعا they tell you the hardest on the human being is the three transitional. They tell you when you're born, when you die, and when you're resurrected. Those three, the hardest. And that is why Yahya wa Isa alayhim salam wa salamu alayya yawma wulidtu wa yawma amutu wa yawma ub'ath hayya. Three. Because when you're born, shaitan comes, stabs you. ما من مولود إلا ويستهل صارخة. Every newborn, he cries because of shaitan comes, stabs. Here is the second moment which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم explained his hadith. When you're about to die, hadith البراء بن عازب رضي الله عنهما في مستدرك الحاكم وقال على شرط مسلم ووافقه الذهبي. شوف. A group of angels. يا إخوة, when you're about to die, there are two groups of angels who come before the arrival of the angel of the death. يعني we call them the assistants. They assist him. And we take this from the hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه regarding the man who killed 100 souls. When he's about to die, the two groups actually arrived at the scene. Angels of mercy, angels of punishment. They actually arrived, each group wanting to take his soul. If the person is a believer, we ask Allah to be of them. Angels of mercy, they arrive. He's laying down. They have very cheering faces, bright as the sun. And they brought with them a shroud from Jannah. Shroud. Shroud for the soul. You see, we shroud the body. But Allah sends the angels with shroud for the soul. And sent odor from Jannah. And they come and they sit in front of the deceased as far as his eyesight reaches. يعينهم. فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون. This is the talk of those angels. When the soul is about to reach the throat, he's about to die. We come and sit in front of him and he sees us and we are closer to him than you. They are addressing the living, his family members. This is the time, brothers and sisters in Islam, when tawbah is over. No more tawbah. Because the world of the unseen became seen. You see, you're supposed to believe that angels exist without seeing them. But now you're able to see them. And this is the time when the Pharaoh made that statement. Ament. Too late. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam says they begin giving the glad tidings to that person. Abshir. We came to give you the glad tiding of what to come. Jannah. Allah is pleased with you. You did good with your life. Grieve not over your children, over your wealth. Look forward to what to come. Paradise. In it, whatever you desire. Whatever you want. Look, at this time, the believer will love to meet Allah. He will say, let's go. I'm ready to go. Take my soul out. Yes. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة. ابن عباس يقول عند الموت ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون نزلا من غفور رحيم. يا الله. If this is said to you, هذا في القرآن سورة فصلت. Indeed, those who believed Allah is their Lord. الإيمانه. إيمانه. Faith. Firm belief that my Lord is Allah. He made me. He created me. He is the creator. He is the sustainer. He is the sovereign. He is the one giving me the life that I have. And he is the one who will ordain death upon me. He is the one who will raise me after I die. And he is the one I'm hoping to forgive my sins in the day of resurrection. I believe that. I have firm belief. اعتقاد صادق. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله. Our Lord is Allah. يعتقد. Is not wishy-washy. رضيت بالله ربا. Not only believing, actually loving it. Loving that Allah is your Lord. I am pleased with Allah to be my Lord. وبالإسلام دينا. And I am pleased that Islam is my religion. I am pleased, I am proud of my Islam. I love Islam. I love Allah. I love His Messenger. I love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I love His Sunnah. And I will give it precedence over my parents, over my ancestors, over the hearsay, over the bid'ah. That type. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Then they remained steadfast. Steadfast. Five times every day. I will strive, Ya Rabb. I will make it to the masjid. I will do my best. I will not neglect my salah, Ya Rabb. I will not. Ya Rabb, I'm gonna plan my day around the salah. I'm not gonna plan my salah around my day. I'm gonna look at my schedule today, Ya Rabb. What time I'm gonna be at Dhuhr time? I'm gonna be near Abu Bakr. Then I'm gonna plan to go to Abu Bakr. Or I'm gonna stop in a park and have my wudu and pray in the park. The salah, praying, sitting down, the mandatory salah is invalid in a car or a truck. Is invalid. Al-qiyam, standing, is a pillar of a salah. Pillar. وَالْعَمَلْ يَسْقُطْ بِدُونُ الرُّكْمِ. Unless there is circumstances. Salah. Zakah. Ya Rabb. It's my money, Ya Rabb. Take everything, Ya Rabb. Mahawal, what makes the difference? What distinguishes? What is the distinction between a believer in the meaning of Allah and someone who does not meet Allah? You give up your nafs, you give up your wealth for that meaning. For that meaning. The commitment. The belief must be followed by a commitment. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ. هذا اعتقاد. وعمل القلب. Then comes in the physical actions and the saying of the tongue. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Steadfast. Look, when they are about to die, angels descend. They sit in front of him. Of course, as soon as you see angels, naturally, you're going to be scared. And you know when you see angels, that means your time is up right away. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا. Don't be afraid. Chill. Relax. Relax, you're okay. You know, I can't, you know, when you go through surgery, نسأل الله أن يعافينا جميعا, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you good health. You know, you get that anesthesia providers who are supposed to put you to sleep. Hopefully it's a legitimate surgery, you're not trying to get high. But they arrive at the scene and, listen, we're just going to give you a little shot. And after that, you're going to go to sleep and things are going to be okay. You're not going to feel anything. And when you wake up, we're going to be there for you. We're going to take care of you. It's exactly the same thing. Almost. Fear not. Regarding the grave, يا إخوة والله الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم made that statement. Having been that I'm afraid that you're not going to bury your deceased, لسألت الله أن يريكم عذاب القبر. يعني that first night in the grave, out of this world, Rasul says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, has it been that I'm afraid that you're not going to bury your deceased? I would have asked Allah to show you what happens in the grave to the deceased. But I'm afraid you're not going to bury your deceased because you want to protect them. Fitna. Fear not. What about my children? What about my money? وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Grieve not over them. We'll take care of them. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. Glad tidings of Jannah, which you were promised in the dunya. الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوْعَدُونَ. You were promised that Jannah in the dunya. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We used to be, by the way, your guardian in the dunya, and we will be with you in al-akhirah. When you wake up, remember the anesthesia? When you wake up, we'll be there with you. We'll be there. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسَكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. This is when the true believer, Ya Rab, take my soul. I'm ready to go. He detached. He split from this world. He said, let me go. Let me leave. And Allah then loves to meet him. Look at the other end of this. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعيدنا والمسلمين. A disbeliever, الكافر. Oh. Someone who came into this world, lived as he pleased. قل لك حرية. أنا حر. حر يا سيد اشرب بقى. اشرب عند الموت. يا حر. Oh. He just want to be liberated from Islam and the work. الكافر. Angels. Scary. Scary. Their faces terrorize the deceased. They are called the angels of punishment. They arrive and they sit in front of the deceased as far as his eyesight reaches. When he sees them, زي ما كنا بنقول عادنا في مصر يقول لك ايه جالك الموت يا ترك الصلاة. كنا بنقول كده. Death came to you, you used to neglect salah. الموت هو يجي. Also, they are bringing with them masuh, a shroud for the soul, but from fire. Subhanallah. And they sit in front of the deceased. And you know what they tell him? أبشر بسخط الله وبغضبه وبعذابه. We want to give you the glad tidings. Sarcastic, yeah. The wrath of Allah is upon you. The anger of Allah is upon you. And the punishment of Allah awaits you. By the way, this one, as soon as he sees and he hears, his soul runs away inside his body. The soul of the believer, because he's ready to go. Even so, it's a difficult process, but it will come out like a drop of water from a water bag or something. But this one, his soul runs inside his body. For him to let his soul leave, they must beat him up. ولو ترى إذ يتوفى الذين كفروا الملائكة يضربون وجوههم وأدبارهم.
If you would just see how the angels extract the soul of a disbeliever from his body, beating his rear and his front. Get out!
ولو ترى إذ الظالمون في غمرات الموت والملائكة باسطوا أيديهم أخرجوا أنفسكم. أخرجوا أنفسكم.
Get that soul out. Let's go. Let's no delay. This is going to happen. Come on. The angel of death is about to arrive. We got to take that soul out quickly. Get it out.
فيكره لقاء الله.
At this time, فليس شيء. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أكره إلي مما أمام.
He hates to meet Allah. Allah then will hate to meet him.
And this happens, يا إخوة, in the time of burial.
Also, when the deceased is carried, his soul actually rejoins his body in a way, not like the human way, but his soul will be next to his body, and the soul will say, قدموني, قدموني. Let's go, let's go. هذا الحديث في البخاري, حديث أبي سعيد الخدري, إذا حملت الجنازة على الأكتاف أو أكتاف الرجال, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the janazah is carried, if the person was righteous, he will say, let's go, let's go. Let me go, come on, rush. لذلك من السنة, it is the sunnah that you rush with the burial. Don't wait until you send him to Africa. Why? Why? أسرع. And if he was not righteous and pious, if he was a wicked, a disbeliever, he will say, Ya waylaha, ya waylaha, ayna tadhhabuna biha? Woe to me, woe to me, where are you taking me? Slow down. He's hating the meeting of Allah, he's trying to delay it. And when he is in the grave and he is showing his place in Jannah, he will say, Ya Rab, the believer, Ya Rab, أقم الساعة. Ya Rab, can you make the hour come now? Can you make the hour come now, Ya Rab? Can quickly I go through the time of al-Barzakh so I go not only meet you, Ya Rab, but to also to meet my family members. And to meet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rab. The other one, when he is showing his place in hell, Ya Rab. لا تقم الساعة. Don't make the hour come. Which of the two brothers and sisters in Islam we belong to? Which of the two? أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون وتضحكون ولا تبكون وأنتم سامدون. Do you think this is a fairy tale? Do you think this is a hearsay? Do you think this is a sci-fi? This is true. All of this is true. It's up to you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, faith is sayings and actions. Outward action attest the inward faith. Your amal yusaddiq i'tiqadak. It's easy to say Rabbuna Allah, but it is difficult to remain steadfast, to do what Allah wants you to do. And that is where you need to strive. Sufyan ibn Abdullah al-Thaqafi radiyallahu anhu, kama inda Muslim, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said this to him, قل لي في الإسلام قولا لا أسأل عنه أحدا بعدك. Tell me a simple thing about Islam that I do not need to ask no more question. That's it. You know what he said to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? قل, say, آمنت بالله, I believe in Allah, ثم استقم, then remain steadfast. That is what Islam is all about. But you have a choice. You have the freedom of choice. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us to make the right choice. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we're coming to you today with a chance. And I always look at this verse at the end of Surah Al-Kahf. شوف, فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. If you're hoping to meet Allah, if you're hoping in that meeting, you better take with you a righteous deed. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed our community with a new cemetery in Bennett. Ya ikhwa, if I die in this town, please do not bury me here. Bury me in Bennett, please. I wouldn't like to be buried next to people placing the picture of the deceased on the grave. Ma'alish, yeah. I don't know where is the students of knowledge. Oh, this is out of this world. A Muslim places a picture of the deceased on the grave. A group of brothers are running the affairs of this cemetery. I have been there, يعني, helping out in burials. MashaAllah. MashaAllah. The Sunnah, and they always call. By Allah, I give them this. They call me. Brother Fuad, he calls me, says, Sheikh, we would like to do this. What do you think? I research, I go look for the evidence, and I tell them, do this and do that. They are striving. This is could be our final abode, me and you. But the cemetery now is threatened by flood. Now, because it is not having boundaries, when it rains, all the water comes into the cemetery and it goes into the deceased, and this affects the body. In a way, it's not good to have this. Add to this, things are falling apart. There is a study here, which they put together, regarding what needs to be done. And I encourage you to ask the brothers and question what they are going to do with this money. But they are looking to raise $140,000. So far, they raised $40,000 from Masjid An-Nur and Masjid As-Salam, I believe. They came today to raise that balance. I know we've been bugging you for the last 2 weeks. Alhamdulillah, and you did good, mashallah. We raised over $200,000 for the community project. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, CVA raised almost, I believe, $100,000 last week. But this is the community work. This is the work of the community that we need to invest in. After the salah, we're going to stand. I'm asking you kindly. We have a brother here who can actually shut the doors until you, if he's going to have guards around the doors. I told him that you cannot do that in Abu Bakr. We're not going to do that. But if we have to, we may have to do that. We need to raise that money. And here is the study, and Brother Fuad is right here. Ask him questions. And the board, of course, his other board members. But we need to raise that fund. In 5 minutes after the Salah, please, brothers and sisters in Islam, help that cause. That can be your grave. That can be my grave. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.